Before, ladies and gentlemen, I wanted the perfect smartphone. Cool, sexy, and expensive. So I tried to give away my old cell phone, but nobody wanted it. I even tried to give it to my little nephew, Jimmy. I said, "Jimmy, you want a free cell phone?" "No, Uncle, I don't want your stupid cell phone. You tried to give it to me 3 times. And he walked away, laughing at me. You know, I even tried to lose this phone, but something always went wrong. Now, I love it. Why did I change? Well, that's a long and difficult story. The first time I tried to lose my phone, I was on a bus in Zhongshan East Road in Taipei. The bus was really crowded and everybody was looking at their smartphones. And you probably notice, when people look at their smartphones, they don't see any other person. They don't see anything else around them. So I decided to test this. I yelled out, "Fire!" So I yelled out, "There's a bomb on the bus!" So I yelled out, "Your mother just got on the bus! What? Hey, where is she?" It's true. So I took out my cell phone and I put it on the seat behind me because I knew nobody cared. Because I knew nobody would notice. At my stop, I got off the bus and I walked down towards the pedestrian crossing. I was almost there when I heard those two words, "Hey, mister, hey, mister." I turned around and there was a little 10-year-old kid. "Hey, mister, is this your cell phone?" "No," I said. "But mister, it must be your cell phone because it was on your seat in the bus." "Really?" I said. "Sure," he said. I wanted to, but I didn't. I took my cell phone and I went home. I was sad and depressed. When I'm sad and depressed, I take myself to see a movie so I can feel better. Then I got another idea. I would go to the early movie because there are no people. The next day, I got to the movies at 10 a.m. I bought 1 medium popcorn, 1 medium Coke, I walked to the theater. It was empty. Perfect. I sat up the back. The movie started. I ate my popcorn. I drank my Coke. And near the end of the movie, I took out the cell phone and I dropped it into the empty Coke container. Then I rolled down the top. Well, the movie ended and there in the corner was a bored 17-year-old kid with a trash can. And he looked a little bit familiar. So I walked down and I dropped my containers into the trash can and my cell phone hit the bottom of the trash can with a thud. Perfect. I walked out of the theater and I was walking towards the escalator when I saw the little kid from the bus stop the previous day. And I thought, oh my God, he found my cell phone. But I looked at his hands and there was nothing in them. So I relaxed. Then I heard those two words and I stopped relaxing. "Hey, mister, hey, mister." I didn't want to turn around, but I did. There was the bored 17-year-old kid from the trash cans. "Hey, mister, is this your cell phone?" "No," I said. "But mister, it must be your cell phone because you were the only person in the theater." "Really?" I said. "Sure," he said. I wanted to, but I didn't. I said, "Kid, how did you find my cell phone?" He said, "Well, mister, when those two containers hit the bottom of the trash can, they made a funny sound. So I checked them and I found your cell phone." By now, we were at the escalator. I looked at these two kids, and they looked like brothers. So I said to the big one, "Is that your brother?" And he said, "Yeah, mister, he's here for lunch. And you know, yesterday, he found a cell phone on the bus. And he gave it to a foreign person just like you. Isn't that amazing? 2 times in 2 days. No, kid, it's not amazing. And I snatched the cell phone from his hand. I went home. I was sad and depressed again. And when I'm sad and depressed, I like to read books. The next day, I was reading a book about a king of Persia, a very wise man. And one day, his son came up to him and he said, "Hey, mister, hey, mister." And the king said, "Don't call me mister. I'm your father, call me daddy." "Daddy, daddy, today I was in the city watching the carpet makers making carpets. And you know, they always make a mistake. They always make an error so the carpet's not perfect. Are these people fools or idiots?" "No, son, they're not fools or idiots. The carpet makers believe that things which are perfect can only belong to God. And this world, our world, is not perfect. But things which are not perfect can grow, change, become bigger and better." And I thought, wow, I'm not perfect, but at least I can grow and change, become bigger and better. Then I thought about my cell phone. This is the most imperfect piece of junk in Taiwan. But if I can learn to accept it, I'll become a better man. If I learn to accept its imperfections, I'll change and grow, become bigger and better. And that's what my cell phone teaches me. But thinking about it, if this cell phone is not perfect, then it could change and grow, become bigger and better. So maybe it became a smartphone. Let's test it together. We'll give it a question, an easy one. Cell phone, what is 1 plus 1? Hey, yeah, I should have bought an Apple. Come on, let's check.